bright light. Said it gonna set my soul, gonna set my soul on fire. Got a whole lot of money that's ready to burn, so get those stakes up higher. There's a thousand pretty women waiting out there. They're all living, the devil may care. And I am just a devil with love to spare. So viva Las Vegas, viva Las Vegas. How I wish that there were more than the 24 hours in the day. Even if there were 40 more, I wouldn't sleep a minute away. Oh, there's blackjack and poker and the roulette wheel, a fortune won and lost on every deal. All you need is a strong heart and a nerve of steel.
Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas!
Viva Las Vegas, with your neon flashing and your one-armed bandits crashing, all those hopes down the drain. Viva Las Vegas, turning day into nighttime, turning night into daytime. If you see it once, you'll never be the same again. I'm gonna keep on the run, I'm gonna have me some fun. If it cost me my very last dime, if I wind up broke, oh well, I'll always remember that I had a swing in time. I'm gonna give it everything I've got. Lady luck, please let the dice stay hot. Let me shoot a seven with every shot.
Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas! Viva! Shop. Let's go see what's going on with him. He's got Mark here with his 1964 El Camino, fixing to take it out of here.
So what are you telling me, dude? Your dad's owned this for how long? Huh? 1964? He bought this car brand new.
Two owners, second owner.
He's the second owner.
Second owner. Comes from New Mexico.
Now hold on, bud. We just put a late model Chevy engine in it over here. Okay?
350.
You bought that at the junkyard.
Yeah.
Because you're poor like me. You know, this is poor boy shop. Got the brand new, we got the late model radiator going. But you're going to clean all that up. So this thing's been sitting in the mud since 1973.
That's it.
Mexican dirt.
New Mexican
dirt. Okay, whoa, bud. Let's get the New Mexico part in there. I don't want to get anybody jealous. Well, I'll tell you what, dude, you got a good start here. This thing doesn't even have any rust on it, man.
No rust.
That's what it's like getting cars from Mexico, bud. Oh, so, is your dad, how old's your dad, man?
I don't even know. 65.
You don't even know?
65.
You think he might have a heart attack, dude, if he sees this thing start up?
He wants to see it.
I think we ought to get a little start action going. Why don't you pour a little gas in there, get the, you know, we'll get it started. See if it even starts, because we know it needs exhaust, right? We got the brand new 700R4 transmission in. Let me see if that thing even starts, bud. Get some gas in that thing. Is there any in it?
There's gas.
Let's try it out. Well, damn, there you go. One more job well done at Southwest Rod and Custom. Right?
That's right.
Me personally, I'd make a hot rod out of it. What the? Okay. I'd make a rat rod out of it to start out with.
Paint it flat black.
Now hold on, bud. You were talking candy apple green, dude.
Green is not green.
Man, I can't believe it. You're gonna take this automobile, this classic 1964 automobile, and you're gonna make a lowrider out of it?
No, just candy blue.
Now it's candy blue. You said candy green a little while ago, bud.
It's blue now.
So are you and your boy gonna build this car or what?
Yeah.
So you've been
to take it home and paint it.
You've been saving this car for how long, dude?
A lot of years.
For your boy, right? Since he was a kid. I remember you talking about it 15 years ago, man.
It's his car.
It's been parked out in back of my shop for a year, dude.
He's fixing to drive it.
Well, are you going to bring it back so we can check it out?
Yeah.
And what's your dad going to think of that old monster?
Well, he's going to he's gonna like it.
Let me guess, you're gonna drive it to New Mexico, right?
I'm gonna car haul it down there so we can drive it.
Well, Dad, I hope you like your son's car. He's fixing up for you, and always remember me, okay? Because I'm the one that got it running for him. All right. All right, man. Well, let's get that thing loaded up and you get the hell out of here because we got a lot of fucking work to do, bud, besides this thing. How's that sound?
That's it.
Well, get her done.
Well, they got it all loaded up and it's ready to leave our shop. All we did to this one was put the engine in.
What are you doing?
It's all loaded up.
We already got it loaded and ready to go.
I know. Just saying goodbye to one more job.
Okay. Mark's got it loaded and we're ready to roll, so there you go, dude.
Saturday the 17th of
January
2009.
We'll see when it's all finished.
Two or three months.
Yeah, okay. 2 or 3 months, yeah.
Go ahead and show a picture of that one over there.
Let me ask you something.
That's the kind of restoration it's going
to be. Oh, okay, yeah, sure. So what, you plan on taking it to Earl Shives for that type of restoration?
Earl Madridos. 3 months?
3 months, dude.
El Madridos.
Yeah. El Madridos? That's in Frisco. Where's that at, dude?
Forney,
Mexico or Texas?
Texas.
Man, you need to get out of here. I got a lot of work to do, buddy.
Morning, he brought my letter back. She wrote about it. Return the sender, address unknown, no such number, no such song. We had a quarrel, a lover's spat. Send a special deed.